Some art is considered to be priceless. When it comes to selling them of apparently incalculable worth, however, people may make astronomical sums when the gavel falls. Hey guys, and welcome back to the channel. For this video, we will discover Jimson Weed White Flower No. 1 by Georgia O'Keeffe, $44 million art piece. But before anything else, please leave a like on the video. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell down below so you won't miss our videos. Without any further ado, let's hop on right to the video. Georgia Toto O'Keeffe was an artist from the United States. Her paintings of magnified flowers, New York skyscrapers, and New Mexico landscapes were well known. O'Keeffe has been dubbed America's mother of modernism. In 1905, O'Keeffe enrolled in the School of the Art Institute of Chicago and then the Art Students League of New York for formal art instruction. She worked as a commercial artist for 2 years in 1908 because she couldn't afford to continue her studies, and then taught in Virginia, Texas, and South Carolina between 1911 and 1918. She studied painting over the summers between 1912 and 1914 and was exposed to Arthur Wellesley Dow's ideas and theories, which focused on personal style, design, and interpretation of things rather than attempting to imitate or depict them. As shown in the early phases of her watercolors, from her studies at the University of Virginia, and more dramatically in the charcoal drawings she created in 1915, that led to complete abstraction. This prompted a significant shift in her feelings about and approach to painting. In 1917, art dealer and photographer Alfred Stieglitz staged an exhibition of her work. She taught and completed her studies at Columbia University's Teaching College for the following 2 years, 1914 and 1915. At Stieglitz's suggestion, she relocated to New York in 1918 and started working professionally as an artist. They formed a professional and personal bond, which culminated in their marriage in 1924. O'Keeffe produced a wide range of abstract art, including close-ups of flowers, such as the Red Canna paintings, which many people mistook for female genitalia, despite O'Keeffe's repeated denials. The attribution of women's sexuality was also fueled by Stieglitz's graphic and sensual pictures of O'Keeffe, which he had shot and displayed. O'Keeffe and Stieglitz lived together in New York until 1929, when O'Keeffe started spending part of the year in the Southwest, which inspired her paintings of New Mexico landscapes and animal skulls, such as cow's skull, red, white, and blue, and ram's head white hollyhock with little hills. After Stieglitz's death, she moved to the Georgia O'Keeffe home and studio in Abiquiu, New Mexico, where she remained until her death in Santa Fe. The Georgia O'Keeffe Museum was founded in Santa Fe after her death. Jimson Weed White Flower No. 1 by Georgia O'Keeffe, painted in 1932, sold for $44,405,000 in 2014, more than three times the previous world auction record for any female artist, nearly doubling the top estimate of $15 million and becoming the world's most expensive painting by a female artist ever sold. Joe Mitchell's Untitled, sold at Christie's New York in May 2014, surpassed the previous auction record for any work by a female artist at $11.9 million. The auction also shattered O'Keeffe's previous record of $6.2 million. Jimson Weed, a Datura species, was a favourite of O'Keeffe's. She disregarded the position of its seeds and let it grow wild on her terrace. In this artwork, originally named Miracle Flower, she paid homage to the bloom. Elizabeth Arden, the cosmetics mogul, commissioned Jimson Weed to design the new Gymnasium Moderne of her Fifth Avenue salon in New York City. The unfurling flowers were placed in the workout area to encourage customers to stretch. Arden paid $10,000 for O'Keeffe's biggest flower arrangement to date. The house's entire selling price peaked at $46 million, but due to the rise of O'Keeffe's flower, the total sale price soared to $75.4 million. The artist's work, which was sold in three pieces to support the Georgia O'Keeffe Museum's acquisition fund, totaled $50.4 million, or more than half of the entire selling price. On the old Santa Fe Road, 1930-31, which sold for $5.1 million against an estimate of $2 million to $3 million, was the second most expensive work in the auction. According to reports, there were seven bids for Jimson Weed before it sold to Lisa Dennison, chairman of Sotheby's North and South America, who was bidding on behalf of her client. The artwork is a startlingly strong and beautiful expression of the artist's mature purpose and style, according to Sotheby's catalogue description. O'Keeffe is most known for her large-scale paintings of enlarged flowers. Reportedly said that she intended to paint them in such a way that even busy New Yorkers would have to take a moment to admire them. At Sotheby's, this was definitely the case. Until about 1966, the artwork was in the possession of the artist's sister, Anita O'Keeffe Young. It had previously been auctioned at Sotheby's New York in December 1987. when it sold for $990,000, just over its low estimate of $900,000. And again in December 1994, when it sold for $1,047,500, just above its high estimate of $1 million. Would you pay that much for a painting? Let us know in the comment section below. That's it for today. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on that notification bell so you'll never miss out on any future content we'll produce for you guys. We're signing off now, but we'll be sure to catch you all in the next one.